Okay, I get it, I know, but it's our last video and I'm just really, really sad to lose Fairy Garden Fridays. Yeah, you're right. You're right, I need to finish strong. My fairies need a home. You're right. Okay, I can do this. I can do this. Buck up, Lindsay, let's go. Welcome back to Fairy Garden Fridays. I'm so excited to see you again. Really, I missed you a lot. And this is our final week, which means we are putting our finishing touches on our fairy garden. And I'm really, really excited for this, guys. I know you might be sad, but really I'm not. I'm just super pumped for what we're doing today. And it's gonna be great. So let's bring it back and talk about our rules for the very last time. Can you say them with me? I think by now you should be able to. Ready? One, ask first. Always ask a parent or guardian before you choose anything for your fairy garden. Two, don't be a home stealer. If you're taking anything from outside for your fairy garden, make sure another creature hasn't called it home first. Three, keep the balance. Nothing bigger than your fist and nothing that's already living. Four, share always. Mother Nature has been kind enough to let us use some stuff from outside for our fairy garden, so we need to be kind in response and not use all of it. So, are you ready? Here we go. Isn't it beautiful, guys? But you're right, we've got some finishing touches that we can add to this guy. So I'm thinking today we're gonna do a couple things. I was thinking that it might be nice to use some pine cones, like, you know, this guy or this guy as a tree. But we don't really have very much room. So even though I could take this pine cone here and kind of snap them off and make a nice little tree to go around my house, I want the fairy to have enough room to use the swing set, so I am not gonna do that, but that's definitely something that you could do with yours. I am, however, thinking that it might be nice to have like a little fence kind of going along the back here. I think that would be fun. So I'm gonna use some toothpicks and some popsicle sticks. You know me, that's all I use. Not really, I use other things. I have lots of things here on this table. So I'm gonna break my popsicle sticks in half and then I'm just gonna sit them inside. Ooh, look at this one. It's already half a different color. That's so fun. Tells me exactly where to go ahead and break it off at. This is nice because it adds some color. If you've got just regular popsicle sticks at home, it would be nice to paint them first and then add them to the patio section of your yard. Ooh, look at this one. This one looks awesome. Let's snap him in half. Go ahead and put him in. That looks really good. Okay, let's finish up this fence area with just a couple more pieces to kind of hem it in. Maybe if I can break this popsicle stick. Gosh, that was a hard one. Just one there and one there. And I'm gonna have to rearrange my lights around my patio just a little bit. They did move when I added that fence. Perfect. Look at that patio. That is a place I would like to hang out. Awesome. So, other last minute touches. I have kept these dried flowers here for 8 weeks. Just for this purpose, because I think it would be really great to add some of them to our fairy garden, especially these guys here. So I'm just gonna gently, or not so gently, chop those off. maybe get a little pollen in places. That's fine. Just to add some touches of color. Now I'm doing this at varying heights, just to kind of give us some dimension going on here, but I think that's really fun, guys. I've got this little dried flower here that might look really good placed next to that guy. I think we're done. I think we're done, guys. Doesn't it look awesome? I mean, I am just so excited for the fairies to come see this guy. It's colorful, it's got so much fun stuff for them to do, and it's got friends. We're done, guys. This looks amazing, and I can't wait to see what your finished product looks like. Make sure, for the last time, you drop a photo of your fairy garden in the comments below. I personally will be looking for each and every one of you in those comments. So don't let me down, okay? I've loved hanging out with you guys for the last 8 weeks, and I hope you've loved hanging out with us too. Make sure you come to the parks and you enjoy the nature around you, but you also keep an eye on your fairy garden. Some practical things to remember: that if you are gonna water the plants that you've added in your fairy garden — so I chose succulents because they don't take a whole lot of water — but if you are gonna water the plants in your fairy garden, make sure you take out anything that might not take to water really well. So I would probably remove our swing set and our campfire and our tent, just because I don't want those to get waterlogged, and I would add them back in later. But other than that, I think you guys are ready to go. I think it's time that I deemed you craft wizards.